Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jen and this is Miss Photogenic in Style. If you're a new subscriber, thank you for stopping by. I create videos and share with you my love for luxury fashion and what's in style. For my existing subscribers, thank you so much for your ongoing support and I really appreciate it. So I've hit 400 subscribers and it's creeping up and it's all because of you. So thank you so much for being here. In today's video, I'm going to share with you some of the beauty products that I have purchased over the past few weeks. Most of you know that I am from Singapore. However, due to move to Australia in a few days time, so by the time I release this video, I'm probably on quarantine, getting busy with things around the hotel room. I bought a few things from Sephora, from Chanel, Jo Malone and Kiehl's, and also Gucci. And these products that I bought are in preparation for my trip. I would love to share them with you because I know you ladies would be interested to see it, and I think some of you may already have these products. So let's get started. Now ladies, I will make sure to link all the product details below in the description box to this video. So the first item that I'm going to share with you is a Gucci beauty products. You all know that Gucci has released their beauty product line early this year. So I decided to give one product a shot, and this is the Gucci Poudre de Beauté Matte Naturel. It's a powder, compact powder in my shade, and this is how it looks. It's a beautiful powder compact. This comes with different colors as well, and my shade is number 4. So there you go. This is how it looks. This will be great to carry around my bag for a touch-up when I go out. So that is the first one, and I hope you like it. The second item is a Jo Malone product. Now I'm going to show you my Jo Malone favorite scent. It's the Honeysuckle and Davana cologne. This is my favorite scent, and actually the very first one that I've had for Jo Malone. My husband Snaps bought it for me for my birthday last year, and I've fallen in love with the scent. And because of that, and as I mentioned, because we're traveling, I decided to buy a smaller pack, which is exactly the same. So that's what it is. My next one is my daily beauty routine product. And I use the moisturizer for Kiehl's. Actually, it's the Ultra Facial Cream. I have a bigger tub. I already started using it. But this one is the toner, which is the Calendula Herbal Extract Toner, which is alcohol-free. I bought this because it's got a special packaging of Kiehl's Love Singapore. This product is really good because it refreshes my skin before I apply any moisturizer or makeup. This bottle is about 250 milligram, and I can tell you this will last me for 3 to 4 months because all you need is just a little bit of a dab in a cotton ball or a cotton pad, and that's all you need day and night. When you buy things, of course, they give you travel packs. I'm a sucker for travel packs. I will always take any free product that these stores give me. Thank you. And then next, I also bought a butter stick lip treatment, pure petal. That's also really good to moisturize my dry lips. I've had dry lips since I've been wearing mask. So I've been buying different types of lip balm just to try them out. So I'm gonna try this out as well. Okay. The next one is a bag of Sephora products. I'm gonna make this quick because there's a few products here. The first one is Natasha Denona Glam Palette. The reason why I bought this is because I've been influenced by one of the beauty bloggers, which is Hurley Kim. She's created an instructional video on how to apply this glam palette. So I decided to buy one too. Hi, Early. So here you go. The next one in the Sephora bag is, oh yes, Olaplex number 6, and it's a bond smoother product. It's for my blonde hair. You ladies with blonde hair will swear by this product since it was released. It's really a miracle product because it's very good for dry hair. So what I do with this is I apply it before going to sleep and I just leave it there for hours and then wash my hair. I can also apply this after shower before drying my hair. The next one is a Dior Forever Undercover Foundation in 021 shade. So that's just another travel foundation that I need, so I bought that. And the next one is Dior Lip Glow Addict Lipstick. Let me open this. I think the reason why I bought this is because the limited edition oblique print in pink. You know how I'm addicted to the oblique pattern, so I bought this. Okay, followed by another Natasha Denona lipstick, and the shade is I Need a Nude shade. So this is, I think, like one of the natural ones. I don't know how to do these things. Yeah. So I'm excited to try that. Next one is a facial mask, and it's by Skin Inc. And it's Lines Begone Rose Gold Mask. There you go. Apparently this is designed to help reverse the signs of aging. So I'm going to try this because my skin is aging, so maybe it will work on me. Next is an eye patch. It's a Korean Orchid Elastic Under Youth Eye Patch. I tried one of them a couple of days ago and posted it on my Insta story, and I'm so happy that it worked on me. So I bought another 10 pack. The 10 pack cost $30, followed by an Orchid Elastic Golden Eye Cream. So that's all from my Sephora shopping bag. Before I continue with my next product line, I'd appreciate it if you can hit the like button at the end of this video. And also, if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe today so I can see you in my next videos. There's also that bell button which you can click so that you can be notified with my future video releases. All right, the next one are beauty products from our favorite Chanel. Okay, I'll start with the big shopping bag because these are items that are necessities in applying makeup. I'm talking about different types of brushes. for many years I've used MAC makeup brushes, and I can tell you they've lasted at least 6 to 7 years, and I felt that it was time for me to replace them with Chanel makeup brushes. So I'm going to, let me open them. Okay, the first one that I bought is a powder brush, Chanel powder brush. This is how it looks. Do you want me to open it? Yeah, okay, maybe I should. This is the powder brush. It comes with this little plastic cover with Chanel print, and it's so beautiful. And I think it's made of mink hair, if I'm not mistaken. The next one is a dual-ended eyeshadow brush, which is, and this is how it looks. It's also retractable. That's for the blending. And I think this is just another type of blending. I'm not very good with makeup terms, but anyway, I will use it one way or another. The third one is an eye contouring brush. It's also double-sided and retractable. So dual-ended eye contour number 201. I normally put a darker shade of eyeshadow right by my lid, so I need that one. The next one is a retractable kabuki brush, and this is also, the purpose of this is for travel. So here you go. Got that kabuki hair, so beautiful. I'm sure it's going to make me feel lighter and more beautiful, maybe. But what I love about, of course, all of these Chanel brushes are the packaging. But that's more. So I also bought a retractable foundation brush. So how many of you ladies use a foundation brush? Because we all know that foundation brush is a thing of the past because of all the beauty sponge blender. But I thought I'd get back to the basics and see whether this will work nicely. Let me know if you're still using the foundation brush. Okay, that's how it is. And last but not the least, I got a long wearing liquid eyeshadow. And this is a nude color. What I normally use with this is I use it as a base to my makeup application. Before I put the colors, I apply a cream base. So I haven't tried this before, and I'm really excited to try this and see whether it works for me. If you're interested in these products, as I mentioned, I will link them below. Yesterday I went shopping again, and I decided to buy a few more things from Chanel. So these are the products that I bought. The first one is the Le 4 Ombre. It's an eyeshadow palette, and which I'm sure some of you may know, and the shade is the 226 Rivoli. Next one is the Ultra Wear Flawless Compact Foundation. luminous matte finish in 20 beige shade, followed by a Hydra Beauty Micro Gel, which is used for the eyes. And the reason why I bought this is because I know I'm gonna be traveling and I'll need to make sure that my puffy eyes are well looked after. So I hope it works. I've used this product years ago, but I stopped using it because I think it got too expensive for me, but I thought it's time to revisit this product again because I knew how good it was back then. So I'm excited to give this a shot. I think that's all. Again, more trial packs. And I think the next product that I'm going to buy will be the Blue Serum Eye Gel. Apparently, before using this, you must apply this first so the product will saturate in your skin. Okay. There you have it, ladies. I hope you enjoyed watching this video as much as I had fun sharing the products with you all. I would like to give the following people a shout out for inspiring me to do this beauty vlog as well. So number one is Amy Sutan. She's always releasing videos on shopping, right? Whether it's jewelry, shoes, or clothing. I really enjoyed her video. Followed by my friend Always Antoinette. Also, it's Chex. Hello Lux Cat, who does her monthly favorite haul, which includes beauty products, fashion, and luxury items as well. But when she presents these products, it's really interesting. The next one is Madame MM Style Icon. She's done a few Chanel beauty product blogs. And also, lastly, my good friend Chuck Cherish, who's done a beauty vlog as well. That's all for today. Thank you so much for watching. Please leave your comments below. And if you haven't added me as a friend on Instagram, I would love to see you there so that we can share our day-to-day posts and feeds, also Insta stories, and you can even chat with me there as well. Please take care. And I'll see you next time. Bye.